Hi guys, today in this video I am going to show you a method by which you can run a three-phase induction motor using single phase. Okay, now how we can do that? Let us consider first the case of a three-phase induction motor where the stator windings are in star connection. So these are the phase windings that I am drawing up here. 1, 2, 3. So three-phase windings. Okay, and they are star connected. That means one of the side of each of these coils have been shorted. Now from this end we connect phase wires. So first of all we connect the line wire up here, okay, and then we take the neutral wire here, okay, phase and the neutral wire. Now for this is given from the single phase supply. For a single phase we have two lines, the line and the neutral. Okay, for the middle one what we do for the second phase, we take a capacitor, okay, and connect it directly here. Okay, so this is a method by which you can run a three-phase induction motor on single phase. This capacitor is somewhat rated between like 50 mFD to 60 mFD, something like this. Okay, it is rated between 50 mFD to 60 mFD, and this is a way where you can run a three-phase induction motor using single phase. Now there are certain problems. Let's say the induction motor has a full load current capacity of 3 ampere. If you are going to run the motor by this method, this three-phase induction motor using single phase, what you will see that without any load the motor is going to take around 5 to 6 ampere, that is double the full load capacity. Okay, so you can understand that it is a very dangerous process, and it is in fact one of the not recommended methods of running a three phase induction motor using single phase. There are other methods of running a three phase motor on single phase where we lower down the voltage and the current, but that is another part or another topic. But this is one of the most unrecommended method, and however this method is used in several emergency cases where you need to run the motor for a very short duration of time. As you can understand, the double amount of current, which means it is really unsafe for the motor to being run in this mode on a single phase supply like this, because it is going to take almost double the current on no load only. Forget about giving any load on this. If you are going to put any load on this motor, it is going to take almost 9 to 10 ampere of current, and it is definitely going to burn out the windings. Okay, now how does this work? How does this method works? You have heard about single phase induction motor where what we do, we split the phase into two. Okay, like what we do in a single phase induction motor, basically single phase is given and the line is given, okay, and it has two windings in the single phase motor. One is the main winding, another is the auxiliary winding. The auxiliary winding is given through capacitor. Okay, so in this way what happens, if I plot it here, there are two phases within the machine. One phase is like this, okay, and there is another phase like this. Okay, so there are two phases. Because of two phases there are two unbalanced flux within the machine, and two unbalanced phase is the minimum requirement or the minimum criteria for any induction motor to run. So that's how the single phase induction motor runs. Same thing happens over here. We treat this second phase as an auxiliary winding and this as the main winding, while the third one is connected to the neutral. And just like if you compare the operation of both, it's almost similar, but this is not an auxiliary winding, because in auxiliary winding single phase induction motor the number of turns are different and the resistance is also less than that in case of a three phase induction motors. Okay, so what is going to happen? This is going to burn the windings of the motor. The current it will be taking is much higher, as I shown you here. Now this is the case of a three phase star connected motor. But this is not possible with the delta connected stator winding. Why? Let us see. For a delta connected stator winding, if I just draw the delta connection here, okay, so it is something like this. For a delta connected winding, if you connect three phases, you can see that one phase goes here, another goes here, and the third one goes here. Okay, so between any of the two coil, any one coil, there are two phases available. Okay, like if you see this, if I call this V2, if I call this V2, and this as V3. Okay, so there are two phase voltages between each winding, any two of the winding. But with single phase, it is not possible to make a connection and to supply two phase voltage between any of the winding. Okay, and that's why with delta connected stator we cannot use this method of running the motor. However, this is very unrecommended method. I am again repeating, you should not take this as one of the best methods or one of the recommended methods, because this is going to, you know, endanger the life of the operator, as well as the, it is not good for the motor also. Okay, so that's how you can run the motor for a very short duration of time, for very short duration. Why I am saying this? Because if you take heat generated as I square RT, this is the maximum heat generated, I square RT, if you are taking this, so as the current is rising, you will have to lower down the time, and the heat is directly proportional to square of the current. That means if the current is being doubled, the I square will be 4 times, and hence you will have to reduce the time of operation of the motor from normal to 4 times. That is, if you are running the motor for 4 hours, you will be able to run this motor for only 1 hour with this method. Okay, however, this is not recommended. So that's all for today. Thanks for watching. If you have liked this video, please like, comment, and share your feedback with us. If you have any question, put that in the comment section below. I will be happy to help you. And do not forget to subscribe. Share this video with your friends. This is Vivek Choubey signing off. Thank you.